President Duterte fires several government officials allegedly involved in corruption. Duterte named the officials during his state address. The fired officials were from the Philippine Environment Department, and their cases include issuance of free patent titles and illegal fixing transactions.
We are not proclaiming that we have gotten rid of corruption. There is still corruption in this government and any other government that will come after me and in the past. Meron talaga yan. If there is a running bureaucracy and there is money involved and there are a lot of tables where the papers would go through, there will always be corruption. Kung walang ang ayaw ninyo wala, diserahan mo ang gobyerno. But then again, choose which way to go. The most that we can do is to fight it.
Late last year, Duterte ordered the Justice Department to investigate the entire government for corruption until the end of his term in 2022. President Duterte now over talking about the West Philippine Sea issues. The topic has been making headlines after the chief executive made new statements on the territorial row between Manila and Beijing. That includes saying he was only joking about his 2016 campaign promise of riding a jet ski to the contested area. He also challenged, then backed out from a debate against a former magistrate of the Supreme Court on the issue. Duterte says he would now prioritize talking about issues concerning the pandemic.
We will be discussing now COVID-19, dalawa lang, COVID-19 and the West Philippine Sea issue. So unahin natin ang COVID-19. Kasi ang COVID-19, nakakamatay. Ang West Philippine Sea, hindi maraming mamatay sa consumption, pero hindi ako.
Quarantine restrictions and the NCR plus bubble eased. President Rodrigo Duterte has approved placing Metro Manila, Bulacan, Cavite, Laguna, and Rizal under a general community quarantine, but with heightened restrictions starting this weekend until the end of May. Under the new classification, only essential travel in and out of the NCR plus areas will be allowed. Indoor dine-in services are also permitted at 20% capacity, outdoor dining at 50%. Outdoor tourist attractions can be opened at 30% capacity, but entertainment venues like bars, amusement parks, as well as indoor sports and tourist attractions are still prohibited to operate. Religious gatherings and gatherings for necrological services and funerals, on the other hand, are allowed at 10%. COVID-19 cases have declined in previous days, but some hospitals have said that's not enough to ease restrictions.
We're hoping that it will drop further. We're still in the high 100. So, and it's only been about 7 days since we reach the less than 200 mark. One thing though is we are seeing less and less walk-in visits in the emergency room, meaning less COVID patients in the ER, although we still take care of a lot of the severe and critically ill patients, and so our ICUs are still full.
Halos wala na po mga pila sa emergency room at medyo decongested na yung mga COVID beds.
Oo.
At minsan dun sa medyo critical pa rin po yung mga ICU beds. Mm.
The Philippines extends its ban on travelers from India until the end of May to arrest the spread of the COVID-19 variant first detected in the South Asian nation. It also added two more countries to the travel ban, Oman and the United Arab Emirates. Starting May 15 until the 31st, those with travel history to these two countries within the last 14 days are not allowed in the Philippines. The Philippines earlier this week detected its first two cases of the more transmissible Indian variant on two Filipinos who arrived from these two countries.